All right, should we start and see?
We can. I don't see the first applicant, which is a return for 354 Wibblewell Road. Let me just make sure.
Recording? We are recording. Okay.
We are recording. Well, let's see. The second application is for 20 Gedney Way. Mary, is that your application?
Yes, it is.
How are you?
Hi, Mary.
I'm good. How are you guys?
Good. Hi. And the homeowner is on as well?
Yeah, Lauren McCaffrey.
Hey.
Hey, Lauren.
Okay. Mary, can you share your screen?
I can.
Okay.
Okay, so... wait. Yep, there you go, right? All right, so... It's a portico, pretty simple. Let me show you the pictures first. So this is the McCaffrey home, 20 Gedney Way, front, kind of front going around the right side, the rear. These are neighbors, 1, 2, 3, you know, it's basically an area where I think all the houses were built in the 1960s, similar Central Hall colonials. And just to distinguish the front, the McCaffreys would like to, when you look at it, you can see it's kind of plain. So, and actually just to show you the Google Earth, it's a cul-de-sac at the end of Gedney Way. So the project was to add a portico, which is very much in keeping with the style of the house, curved bottom, you know, gable roof. And, you know, to tell you the truth, I didn't think we were going to be going to ARB on this one because it was under $20,000 and pretty simple. So, which is why I didn't do all four elevations, but I just showed you the exterior of the house.
All right, but you got a side elevation of the portico, so they both look the same, I assume, right?
Excuse me?
Both sides, I see you have a side elevation of the portico, right?
Yeah, so, right. We didn't do a side elevation. You know, normally I know you guys want four elevations of the house. This seemed so minimal that I honestly didn't think we were going this route. So here I am.
I think it's okay.
I think it looks good.
Right. Okay. All right. So we're sorry you had to come to us. We'll make it easy for you.
Excuse me. I'm sorry.
We're sorry you had to come to us, but we will make it easy for you.
Okay. I appreciate that. All right, guys. Have a good evening.
Thanks. You too.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, look good.
Okay. So I don't see. Our other applicants are on yet. That's only
so we only have two more, right?
Yeah. The first one is a return from last week.
Right.
And another one is Bill Spade.
All right. So, everybody go get a deck of cards.
I'm going to continue working then.
Yeah. I'm just going to go into my other screen, my work screen, and see if they've emailed me. So I'll be back.
Oh, Bill Spade's probably.
Okay, I see that Bill emailed me, so I told him to log on, that we're waiting for him. And I emailed the other architect, so give it another 5 minutes. Hi, Bill.
Hi, sorry.
That's okay.
It got to me faster than I was expecting.
Mm-hmm. So, are you able to share your screen?
Yes.
Okay. And this is for, hold on, for 780 King Street?
Correct.
Okay. Okay. Whenever you're ready.
Yes. I was thinking I was going to be able to get the photos off of the online submission. But I see they're not, I can't share that screen. So hang on a second. I'm going to open them from, I'm going to show the photos first. I would like to. Let me get them. See if this works. You can see the aerial photo here. Yeah, great. So this is 780 King Street. It's a roughly nine acre property along King Street, just before the town of Mount Pleasant line, which is the line across the map here. It's a kind of a state property. So there's a long winding driveway up to the main house. The main house was built in, we think, about 1920 or 1921, and there are several outbuildings that were constructed as part of the estate. But the original house is a sort of beautiful Spanish style red tile roof building.
Oh, of course.
Now I'm going to, I think I can show photos here. You see the photograph, right?
Yeah, that must be a neighbor's.
What's that?
That must not be the house.
That's the house.
Oh, you said Spanish, so I was thinking.
Well, I guess it's colonial. It's a red tile roof, so aspects of it look more, it's a stucco facade. So I don't know, maybe Spanish style is not quite the right.
I was thinking of one of those houses on 120, you know, those.
Yes, I know what you're referring to, right. You know, it's got very traditional colonial detailing to it. You're correct. That's the front elevation. The driveway comes by, you see it here at the bottom of the screen, and then the embankment down to King Street is right after the edge of the driveway. So there really isn't any front yard, and this house you cannot see from King Street because of both the embankment and the amount of trees on the embankment. So, and it's, the front is hardly used. And part of the reason for this project we're proposing is because the front is so inaccessible, we're trying to create a better accessible entrance from the rear. So that's the front of the house.
Did something happen at this house years ago?
Not that I know of.
Oh, okay. All right. I'm not going to even mention
that. I haven't heard. This is the left side of the house. You see the front portico to the right. The left side has a beautiful porch, outdoor porch with a trellis setup that could be covered. You see these very interesting dormers. on the house, and there's more of those on the rear. So that's the left side, and this is the back of the left side. This portion was an addition probably in the 40s, and it was a done as a flat roof addition. And then off of the master bedroom in the rear, they did both a screened porch and a deck area with the black railing on top of the flat roof. The spaces inside were essentially a maid's area. It's a bedroom and a living area and a little kitchenette in this one-story space on the rear. Our proposed project, we're going to get to there, is off the back of this one-story addition. I will now show you what I think is the right side, or it might be the rear. My computer is being slow. I don't know why it's not showing up. There we are. This is the rear of the house. You see the main original house here, and then that one-story addition I was describing on the right side here. There's an entryway that we're proposing to make changes to as part of this project. That's this rear set of doors. And I guess maybe I'll describe it here. The project we're proposing is a two-car garage on the back of this one-story addition, flat roof, two-story garage. The reason we're proposing the two-story garage, by the way, is the existing garage is a separate structure about 100 yards away in this photo off to the left, orientation of the house, off to the right side of the house, about 100 yards away from the main house. And obviously in the 1920s, that made sense because maybe cars caught on fire a lot back then and they had detached garages. The current owners have lived in this house since the late 70s, have kind of lived with the fact that the garage was detached, but now they're elderly and they would like to get garage space that's attached to the house, and that's part of what we're proposing. The other aspect to this project is this set of stairs up to this set of French doors. That's a sort of sunroom that's on the back side of the front entrance foyer area. And we're proposing to change the center door of this sunroom setup. Sorry, the tree's right in the way. And then add a canopy over that and improve this set of steps and porch so that this kind of becomes a secondary main entrance and would be for guests and the like to be able to enter the house this way instead of at present they go into this little side door. And I think, oh, this is a better photograph of the area that we're proposing to work. So again, the two-car garage we're proposing on the back end of this addition, same width as the width of this addition. This existing door would become an interior door to the garage. The garage doors themselves would be at the back end of this addition onto the driveway. And here you see this rear porch. Right now, this is a set of concrete steps that come straight up to, and the last step is a foot wide just before you have to step into these this set of French doors. And so there really isn't any landing even relative to those steps. So we're proposing to create a porch that's the width of this total set of steps and then add another set of steps out in front of it so that there is a true landing and then adding a roof canopy over it to as protection. Maybe a couple more pictures. Here's a photo from this is the right side of the house showing that rear addition. And again, you sort of see how flat the existing set of doors is on the back and that set of steps, and that's where we're going to create that new porch. Neighboring houses, there's really only two neighboring houses that can be seen from King Street here. This is a farm structure that's across the street, historic farm with a barn. And then I think this next photo is of the other house. This is on the same side of the street, the next property after 780 King Street. And maybe this house is familiar to you. It's very visible from King Street, but in a sort of white colonial style. I think that's it in terms of photos to show you. I think I have to stop the share. I'm going to show you then the plans. Here I'll go first. Here's the site plan of the property.
Yeah.
Oh, all right, not for me. You see this nine and a half acre lot, the winding driveway up from King Street, the existing house here with its prominent portico entrance. Then the driveway comes around to the back over here to the right is this detached garage building.
It's really far.
Yeah, from the house. And then behind it is even an older, I think, turn of the century garage building. It's actually a beautiful little building, but just all used for storage. So this hatched area is where we're proposing to do the addition of the two-car garage. Right now, asphalt paved driveway ends at roughly this line. And from here, it's sort of a dirt and slight gravel pathway. So we're going to pave this additional amount of driveway, and the garage doors will be on the backside here, so that this piece of driveway is the access to the garage. And then you come both to and from those garage doors, the garage from this backside. And then this rear entrance is where we're going to do that improved portico. I'll show you next the floor plan. Use this again. One more down. So here on the back side is the proposed two-car garage. You saw the existing door is going to remain. We're going to block in an existing window that's from an existing bedroom. There's still a window on the side, so that still remains legal. And we basically have a 25 foot wide by 24 and a half foot deep two-car garage. Very simple. The grade of this floor is roughly equal to the existing grade. We actually have a little grade to even chop down to get to that level. It's above grade though to this side. So we're gonna have a side door with a landing and a set of steps to get down to the grade level here. Then that's sort of the simple part of it. This new entrance area that we're gonna create is what this is about. So you can see dashed in the, expanding is a little helpful, the existing steps. So we are going to build a landing on top of those steps. That's one step down from the first floor. And then out in front of that landing or porch, we're going to build another set of steps. And these will have a curve to them, as shown there, a little sidewall that's sloping down with the plane of the steps. And then the walkways out in front, we're going to do as a herringbone pattern brick. There is existing brick. You remember from the photos, existing brick walkways over here, sort of around this existing tree. And we're going to create a new set of walkways centered on this set of doors and using this herringbone pattern brick. I have a couple of sample photos to show you of, you know, the samples we kind of use for ideas. I'll show you that in a minute after I show you the rest of the elevations. So that's the plan. And by the way, so the existing set of French doors, we're leaving the two outer pair of French doors and then replacing the middle pair of French doors with a single swinging entry door. And that'll be done with a metal grill pattern on it to kind of pick up on the grill pattern of the second story screen porch, you may remember. So here I'll show you the elevations. Scale this down a little bit. Here's the front elevation of the house with the grand entryway and grand portico. I just have to scale this down. Here is the right side of the house. I'm just trying to get, maybe you can see the whole picture. I always have the zoom.
I can see it.
You can see the whole thing there, right? So here's the right side of the proposed addition. And what we're trying to do here is replicate the pattern of the crown. It's a crown and gutter around this existing, actually not a gutter, it's a crown around this existing one-story addition. The roof is actually set down and there's a scupper and downspout to drain the roof that's behind this little parapet. So we are going to set down our new roof, match the crown detail around the roof, but we'll have a gutter as part of that as opposed to just crown molding. And our roof is going to be right at plane with the top of this so that we're trying not to interfere with or change this existing top of wall and crown that's on that addition. Maybe just to say, in terms of materials, we're replicating the look of the existing house with stucco finishes on the side, on the elevations, and replicating the windows. You can expand this a bit to show that elevation a little better. So replicating the window size and grill pattern of the existing windows. We're going to do an overhang of the roof over the doors to help a little more protection for the garage doors. Here you can see the side of the proposed entrance modifications for the rear door, new set of steps, the new 5 foot wide landing just below the first floor level, and then a new flat canopy and tapered fiberglass columns for that entrance. Here you'll now see the rear elevation and what that's proposed to look like. So you see the elevation of the garage doors and that end elevation with the existing railing and screen porch in the background there. New proposed entrance here. And so we're leaving, as I said, leaving the existing French doors to either side and this existing crown molding that's about a foot out from the wall. And we're going to build this new canopy over the top of those existing elements and then replace the existing, actually it's a single French door in the middle is the existing door. And we're going to replace that existing French door with a new wood door with a decorative iron grill set in as part of that panel of the door that would be glass with a iron grill pattern over the glass. And then also introducing a replacing the existing transom window with a new transom window, also with the decorative grille in it. These are the new fiberglass, round tapered columns that we're proposing as well. You see the new proposed steps flaring out. We'll have black metal railings to replicate similar pattern and look to the existing railings that are on the house. And then this is the side of that side door coming down onto the grade. And then this is the proposed left side of the house, of the addition. Again, replicating the appearance, it's actually, you can see these are 12 over 12 grill patterns for the windows. So we're replicating that in the new windows. That is the, I said I would show you, I think we go back to here to do the screen stop share. I'm going to show you sample photos of, if I have them, where did those go? It's always a question of where things are when I go find the share screen. I'm not seeing it. I had those photos up here a second ago. Give me one more minute if you don't mind. What happened to that? Did they play that here? I know where it is. There it is. Sorry, one more. It's here now. There. Put this in the middle. So here's a sample of what we're thinking of in terms of that entrance. This is a wider double door. We're proposing a single door. But the look of the canopy, the black door, black grill, the steps and the side walls would be the feeling we're trying to evoke with this entrance. We'll have black metal hand railings on either side as required by code as part of our project. And then also this is samples of photos of the herringbone pattern brick that we're proposing to do as part of those walkways. So that's the quick production review. I can go back to the plans and get those back here if anyone has any questions. Where do the plans go? It's because I've got a, is this the, I don't know where everything goes. It's part of, I think it was another window. Here. That's not it. Sorry, they're here somewhere. And that's not the one I wanted. I don't know what happens to. What's that?
If you go up to window on the top, it should say where it is.
Yeah, it's one of these files. There it is. Sorry. So here, I don't know if you can see this. I probably have to go back to share screen again. Now we're there. So Sorry for taking the time to find that, but that's the proposal. Any questions?
Could we look at the floor plan briefly, actually?
Sure. Is that large enough? Do you want me to enlarge it?
No, that's good.
Good for me. I have a big monitor.
Is there a reason why the, I guess it, I wanted to see the floor plan. It looks like the window on the garage, like if you're looking at what would be the left side as we're looking at it here, right?
The side. This side here.
Yeah, exactly. Like there's a lot of space between the door and the window, and the other side looked more balanced. Those, you know, and it seems from this floor plan that your bottom windows there are across one another, but it's
yeah.
the door that's kind of pushed much more up into the corner. Is there a reason
this door has to avoid a car. So if a car is parked here, someone can still come in this door. And even presumably it's
can we see that elevation?
Sorry?
Can we see that elevation?
Oh yeah. Let's see. So here's that side with the door and window. So the door is, you know, into the rear corner, as it were, of the garage to be as far forward, you know, beyond a car. So somebody can still come in that door, get into the corner of the garage, and then go into the house. That door into the house is right there. The other side, I'll show you the other side again.
It doesn't really bother me just because there's kind of a hodgepodge over there anyway.
Yeah, I agree. There's not really a rhythm of windows.
No, the other side has more, but that side has, I mean, every window and door is, you know, is different.
Yeah. Yeah, and this is very visible coming up the driveway. You see this whole facade even more than you see the front.
So you can see there's a vertical line with the new addition right now, but in reality, it's
true.
It would be flush, right?
Right. There would be no vertical line there. Correct.
Okay.
Did we show a line on the other side?
You need to show it to show what's new and what's existing, but when it's built it'll be
correct.
Seamless.
Yeah. right wasn't even focused on that.
Any other comments from the board?
No,
it looks nice.
It looks very nice.
Quite a grand house, isn't it?
Yes.
Are these the plans that you have on file with me?
Sorry.
Are these the plans that you filed
with? The ones, the last ones I submitted, and I just emailed you. I forgot to email you these plans. So you now have an email with them. But these were the paper ones I submitted last week.
Okay, so we have these on file.
Yes.
Okay, all right, good enough. So I'll stamp it approve and put it in Tom's desk. Tom's bin, I should say.
Okay.
All right. Have
well,
a good night.
Thank you very much. All right. Everybody have a nice evening.
Thank you. You too.
All right. Bye bye.
I don't. I emailed the other applicant at 7:00. She hasn't replied. So I'm assuming she's not going to come on. And we'll schedule her for the next meeting.
Okay.
And our next meeting, let me just double check.
The 16th, I think, right?
Are the holidays get in the way of anything? Let's see. 16th.
It will be the 16th.
And then we jump to January 6th.
I'm not available that night.
On the 16th?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll just send out the agenda, and if everyone can just email me and let me know who's available.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Have a good night, everyone.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Bye.
Night.